Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is factor of safety. Now factor of safety, here I'll write the definition, that factor of safety, that is FOS, is defined as the ratio of ultimate or yield stress to the permissible or working stress. So factor of safety is defined as the ratio of ultimate or yield stress to the permissible or working stress. Next, FOS, that is factor of safety, is used to reduce the value of stress so that a material can be stressed below the maximum stress. So here FOS is used, that is factor of safety, it is used to reduce the value of stress so that a material can be stressed below the maximum stress value, because we don't want the material to operate in the maximum stress region, because if the material reaches maximum stress, after that, even if we reduce the value of stress, then the material would be failing at any low value of stress. So to avoid the failure of material, it is necessary that the material operates below maximum stress. So we divide the value of the stress by a factor, and that is called as factor of safety, to get the permissible or working stress. Next, FOS is always greater than 1. Next, FOS is a number and it does not have a unit. So after this I can write the formula of FOS. So first I'll write down, considering ultimate stress. So when we are using the ultimate stress, so factor of safety, as it is defined as the ratio of, I have written here, ultimate stress. I'll consider first ultimate stress to the permissible stress, or we can say it is working stress. And working stress is that stress to which the object or a material is stressed within its working cycle or working life. Next, considering yield stress, factor of safety is given by yield stress upon working stress. So when we are considering the yield stress, factor of safety is given by yield stress upon working stress, and mostly this factor of safety, where we are having the yield point, yield stress, this is used for ductile materials, whereas ultimate stress upon working stress, this is used for brittle materials. So if, for example, I'll just take an example here, that if, for an example, yield stress, I'll denote it as sigma y, is equal to 400 newton per mm square, and assuming the factor of safety as 4, so therefore working stress will be yield stress divided by factor of safety. Working stress is sigma working, that will be yield stress upon FOS, which is 400 divided by 4, and that gives the value as 100 Newton per mm square. So as we can see, by dividing the yield stress with factor of safety, we have reduced the stress from 400 to 100 Newton per mm square, and this 100 Newton per mm square would be called as the working stress, which would be used when the component or the material is being used during its life. Means whenever we are using that material, it will never cross a value of 100. 100 will remain the maximum stress for that material. And if it is not reaching the value of 400, then the chances of breaking of that material is very rare. So in this video, we have seen what is meant by factor of safety.